I'm John Redman here at Horizon Hobby at iHobby 2011. I'm here with my buddy David Pane, and we're going to talk to you about a couple of new airplanes from E-flite. David, how are you doing today?
Good, good. How are you?
Hey, I know that the Phantom here has been a baby of yours for a little over a year now, bringing it to life and doing everything.
Sure.
Hey, why don't you tell us what's so great about it?
The Phantom, it's a very unusual airplane. It flies, it's got its own specific type of flight characteristics,
yep.
The way it handles, the way it acts, and it's just a mean looking airplane in the air, it really is. And, we're really happy with the way it turned out and the way it flies and the way it handles, and it's a perfect scale jet, you know, it just works.
So, if you can fly a Habu 32,
you can walk into this, not even thinking about it.
And of course, construction-wise, what do we got here?
Construction is very, very similar to the same as the Habu. We have a fiberglass fuselage, which is painted. The wings are built up, sheeted, and covered with ultra coat.
Right.
The tail feathers, that's kind of a big feature for this one. The tail feathers are foam and then sheeted, but they're also pre-jig assembled at the factory. So there's nothing about alignment that you have to figure out as a consumer. You know, we have a full-flying elevator here, but nothing for the consumer to do but four bolts. It's already
bolted
pre-jigged.
Bolted in, it's done.
Pre-done. Four bolts and you're done.
And we know if you get anything off in the back of that
stab, the plane messes with the airplane.
It's horrible. So
absolutely.
You've taken care of that.
That's done.
That's awesome. What about the vertical? Is that molded into the fuselage?
The vertical fin is molded glass, and then of course you just have a wood rudder section here for this pre-covered and ready for you to go, pre-done.
Excellent. So out of the box, flaps mandatory?
Flaps are mandatory out of the box. Optional retracts. Our E-flite electric retracts are optional, but they're a direct bolt in. There is no questions. Actually, with both of our jets too, they come with a set of pre-bent hardened struts. So there's no axle configuration or anything. You just drop in the new struts into the E-flite retracts and go.
And you're ready to go. Power system wise.
Power system is the exact same as the Habu 32 was. It's the Delta V32, our E-flite 80 amp speed control, and the 6S5000 battery pack. Set up exactly the same.
So we both know guys have gone out there and if they've just seen it on the web and they're thinking, how can I hop it up? They went through this on the Habu and such. Talk to us a little bit about the development of that power system. What was the program there?
Yeah, the development of that power system is we wanted to go somewhere where we could give a convenient, price-pointed power system that was accessible through a variety of different reasons and also battery. You know, if we go much bigger than this, then your batteries just go expand hugely in price.
Right.
So the 6S5000 was kind of where we started because it had already started getting on the market with like the 600 helicopters. It was becoming a pretty popular battery. So we kind of started there and built a power system around it that would not only give us good performance, but good flight time. You know, there's all kind of motors and hop-ups out there that can give you these super, super speeds, but you get like a 2 or 3 minute flight and your airplane weighs a ton.
Right.
This kind of, we tried to go right in the middle of everything. Flight time, performance, and cost all together. That was the reasoning behind the whole system.
Excellent, excellent. So multiple hatches, easy access to everything.
Yes.
Wings plug in?
The wings are the same as the Habu. It's a carbon blade spar, real simple to get to. You've got two real large hatches in the airplane. One up here for the battery and then all of your electronics are back here. Servo setup is almost exactly the same as the Habu, but it's one less. You end up with six MC35 servos and then you end up with one 3421 Metal Gear servo for the elevator.
Okay, where the Habu had two because it had two elevators.
Exactly, yeah. And it's just a little bit bigger, you know, more strong servo,
right.
Of course, for the full flying.
Right. Incredible. Trim scheme.
Trim scheme. You know, it's just a really beautiful trim scheme, in my opinion. It shows up really well. It's got some good color coordination to it, and it's a very aggressive but very bright and colorful trim scheme. You know, everything you see here is installed at the factory except for some of the small nomenclature decals. You can kind of chotch it up and make it look to your parking, but all of the main stuff is done at the factory for you, nothing you have to do.
Absolutely, you know, VF-111, the Sundowner, is a very famous squadron in
Absolutely.
The Navy for many, many years. Flew Phantoms, Tomcats, and I think they're flying Hornets, Super Hornets.
Some A4s, yeah.
A4s, yeah. So yeah. Awesome, great job. I gotta say now, let's get in price.
Price? Price is $369.99, and that's the ARF kit.
Okay, you need radio system to complete, the power system and retracts, just like the Habu.
Just like the Habu.
Okay, now the one that's probably gonna upset a few people, because I know I've just recently seen a pushback date on the website, is the availability.
Unfortunately, yes, the availability is now looking and trending towards late December. We're seeing a few things of You know, unfortunately, there's some time constraints and power constraints going on in China right now.
Okay.
Turning the factories on and off. I think that's due to some pollution control and things of that nature.
Whatever
so
the government
decided.
So it's
slowing production down.
It's slowing production down. Bottom line is they had to wait a little longer for the Habu, which I know you weren't happy about
yes,
either.
I was very
You'd
very
much
upset.
Rather put airplanes in everybody's hands. But
I also want them to be right. I don't want to rush them.
And that's what it's all about.
Yeah, the key importance to me is that everybody gets the same airplane that we're flying right now.
Right, right. Awesome, incredible with a Phantom. So now let's go, we've looked at the great one.
Sure.
Let's go look at the Speed Demon.
Sure.
A little fast one up here.
Not to discount the speed
not
of the Phantom.
Not at all,
Phantom's
not at all.
Very close to the same as the Habu.
Absolutely. But the Racer.
Speed Demon, absolutely.
Speed Demon, the Racer for the sport guy. He's a prop guy, he's not an EDF. And that's the Shoestring.
Yes. The Shoestring is our latest. It's follow-on to the Pogo, of course. We had a really good success with the Pogo. You know, the Pogo was designed and built as the sport modeler who wanted to go fast.
Right.
Wanted to race. But it's also a kind of feature to both of these airplanes is they're both legal for EF1 racing category, which is a new class that they've started for racing class electric pylon racing.
Right.
And both of these are actually legal in that class. They're designed to operate in that class. We offer a special motor, a 1250 kV Power 25 4S system that runs it and runs it very well in that class. So you have that option, or you can go with a 3S Power 15 setup if you just want to go a little slower and be the weekend sport
the
flyer.
The weekend sport flyer. Awesome. Completion level?
Completion level is ARF.
ARF
at $149.99.
Great. Availability?
Availability, they should leave the factory sometime this week, so we're looking at about a month.
Month and a half, so Thanksgiving, a little after
Absolutely.
Thanksgiving.
Absolutely, right around the Thanksgiving awesome. Time frame.
Well, David, I know you got more on your plate and other things you got to do here at the show, but I just got to say what you've been bringing out is truly incredible.
Thank you. We appreciate it.
Looking forward to
we
the future.
Trying.
And
yes.
I'm getting hit a lot on the Facebook page about future EDFs, and I know you're not talking. I'm not talking
talk.
Either. I can't either.
I've got things up my sleeve,
but
I can't talk.
I know. I know one thing. You're working all the time.
Great.
Dave, thanks for stopping by and talking to us.
Appreciate it.
Hey, everybody, we'll see you at the next one.